Welcome to the Brief Beginner's Guide for Using Crunchyroll App. This is Daily Tutorials. And before starting, you can subscribe to our channel for more videos and updates. So let's get started. I am already logged in. Make sure you are as well. Today, I'll be explaining about each and every icons present on the screen and how to use it for the optimum results or to get the best shows of anime, manga, and dorama as well. There are five of the icons on the bottom. I'll explain each of them. Starting with the very first icon is the home icon, which is a representation of all of the things that you'll get on the entire Crunchyroll app. The very first one is the show that I'm currently watching and I can continue watching. That is the Ancient Magus Bride. Below is my watch list. I have kept all of the shows in my watch list, and this is the most popular shows. These are just updated shows in Crunchyroll. The Crunchyroll helped to make this. That means these are just shows held by Crunchyroll to make them. The anime that you pet will love, anime for gamers, sports time all the time. So these are all of the options that you will get on your home screen about the overall thing that you will come across the whole Crunchyroll app. On the bottom, you have an option of Go Premium. Tap on it. If you want to get premium on Crunchyroll app or even on the 14 days free trial, you need to get a Crunchyroll premium, and you have three of the options for it. The very first one is the newest one, as to enjoy the newest episodes of anime with no ads. This will cost you $7.99 per month after the free trial ends. The second one is the best deal. You will be a mega fan and you can enjoy the newest episodes of anime with no ads and offline viewing on multiple devices. This will cost you $9.99 per month after trial ends. Third one is the annual mega fan, where you can save 16% by signing up for an annual plan and get everything in the mega fan subscription, and it will cost you $99.99. And if you want to get any one of them, let me choose the best one, that is the mega fan, and tap on start subscription on the bottom. Now you can tap on add credit or debit card and then get started by adding your card number and making the whole payment and being the official member of Crunchyroll. Then you can earn the 14 days free trial and earn all of the facilities given by Crunchyroll. So this is it. So I'll show you the next one, that how the shows will look like when you're gonna watch it. Let me continue watching or choose one of them from my watch list. I would love to watch Darling in the Franxx. Let me tap on it. I'll show you how the shows will look like. So this is basically the Darling in the Franxx, and you can see that it has got 4.5 stars out of 5 and it has 2.5k watching on average. This is a description of the show, the distant future one. You can tap on series details and watch all of them. It has 120 episodes and the publisher was ABC SI. You can also read the description related to this show. So this is the season 1 and we have 120 episodes and you can watch them over here. And if you want to watch more like this, you can tap on more like this next to the episodes, and these are some of the similar type of shows. Tap on episodes, and then what you can do is, if you want to sync all, if you want to sync this episode, you can tap on sync all, but you need to be a mega fan for this. So you can tap on Go Premium, and I've already told you how to get in there. Going back, you can tap on this three unparalleled lines on the left part and then sort it by the newest or the oldest. If you're going to tap on newest, you will get the very new episode here, but of the oldest, the very old one will appear here. So let me tap on the start watching season 1. It's getting started. You can watch the comments as well by tapping on comments. So it has just started. This is the show. Now I'll show you. The gear-like icon on the top right corner will give you an option of autoplay, subtitles, and maintaining the quality. Tap on subtitles. So you have an option of various subtitles that you can keep. You can even make it off, or even you can choose a French one, Italian one, Spanish one, and choose the best subtitles of your own choice. Tap on quality. You can change the quality of the picture or make it auto. You can report a problem if you want to. So this is it. If you want to make it to the broader screen, you can tap on this arrow section and then bring it back to the arrow section again by tapping on the top right corner. So I've just told you how to do it. Getting back on the bottom right, you can see that here is this scrapbook like an icon. Tap on it. This is the something that you can add this show to your watch list. I've just removed it. I can just add to it a watch list again by tapping on it. Going back onto the next is a my list option. Tap on my list option next to my home. You will see see that I have added all of these shows to my watch list. If I want to tap it and make it favorite, I need to tap on this heart-like icon and then turn it to favorite one. Tap on the three-dotted straight line next to it. You can see that I have an option of remove from watch list, series info, and share. I can even share. Tap and share. I can share it to any of the device or copy it to clipboard to any of the friends that I like or maybe any for official use. So this is all of the things that are in my watch list. I can tap on them and watch it again. On the right corner, just next to recent activities segment, you will see pin like icon facing each other. Tap on it. You can see you have an option of filter by series and movies and language. Tap on favorites only. If you'll tap on favorites only and update the filters, you will see the favorite that I had just favorite a moment before. So to get it updated, you can do this. I am going to remove it. And if you want to watch series only, tap on series only and then tap on update filters on the bottom. There's all of the series only. Go back and tap on movies only in the bottom and tap on update filters. You will see all the movies only. So I haven't kept any of the movies to my watch list, so I don't have it here. If you want to, tap on movies only and then you'll add any of the movies that will appear here. Below is a language one where you will see that all of the language one. I'm going to tap on subtitle only and tap on update filters in the bottom. You will see all of the subtitle only. There are none of the subtitle only. Sure, if you want to, you can choose and go into the home section and choose any of the subtitled series or movies and then watch them. Going back to it again, tap on dubbed only and tap on update filters. These are the updated dubbed only shows here. So this is it. If you want to filter it and watch according to you, you can get in here and make all of the things as per your convenience. Tap on update filters in the bottom. Next to the watch list is history option. Tap on history. So these are all of the history. These are all of the shows that I'm watching and have just finished watching. You'll get a history here. Tap on offline. If you have just saved any of your videos offline, you will get to watch it here. But for that, you need to get premium or Crunchyroll. And I've already told you that you can upgrade to Mega Fan to use this feature. And how to get it? I've just already told you. This is it. Tap and browse next to my list on the bottom center. Here you have an option of genres and all. Tap on genres. These are all of the genres of anime, manga, or even drama, where you can see that you have an option of action, adventure, comedy, drama, fantasy, music, and all. Let me tap on music one. So these are all of the popular and the new anime, manga, or drama shows related to music. So you can choose a genre and then choose to watch it. Tap on all next to genre. Here you can see all of the popular one, which goes on by the popular section. These are not typically classified, but they are all merged and just you'll see according to the preference given by the Crunchyroll itself. Tap on this three unparalleled lines next to pin icon on the bottom right. You'll see that this was shorted by popularity. So if I want to short it by alphabetical, I can tap on alphabetical and tap on update shorting at the bottom. I'll see all of the shows according to the alphabet, starting from A to Z. This is it. Going to the next is a simulcast option. Well, simulcast is a feature in Crunchyroll where the shows are broadcasted on the same day as it is released in Japan. That is, it is released simultaneously and the anime fans do not have to wait for a longer period of time. So this is a simulcast season that was broadcasted at the same period as in Japan and it's named as Boruto Naruto Next Generation. There are lots of simulcast season. For that, you can get premium and watch all of them. So this is it. So next to it is my account. Tap on my account on the bottom right. You can see that these are all of the things related to my own profile. My membership plan, my email changing option, the change password option, subtitle language. I can add experience. So I have an option of maintaining all of the privacy and settings throughout it. Tap on this magnifying glass icon on the top right corner. These are the options where I can get into my own watch list or watch all of them. Let me insert here Naruto and tap on this. I'll get the shows related to Naruto or the Boruto and all of them. So this is it. I have just told you how to do it. Here you can change all of it. And for the settings one, you can visit our channel, how to change the password, how to keep maintain a privacy, or how to change or get the dubbed languages, shows only and all of this. You can visit our channel and watch more of it. I have just told you about each and every icon present on the screen and how to use it. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep calm, stay safe, and goodbye.